Today we will discuss about DES, that is data encryption standard, and we first look into the structure of DES. As I had told you in previous session, that DES is based on FISTL structure, so it is a cipher based on the structure of FISTL, FISTL check structure. So after showing this one, the structure of it, we will see a small example, and we'll encrypt using DES step by step so that the concept can be clear to you. So DES is a data encryption standard that you already know. It was first adopted by US federal standards in 1977. So if you look at the history of DES, it starts from 1967, when the FISTL at IBM proposed Lucifer. So Lucifer was a cipher or encryption algorithm developed by IBM, which had block size of 128 bit and key size of 128 bit. Later in 1972, NBS asked for encryption standard, that is, NBS is the standard authority of USA, so they asked for an encryption standard. And in 1975, IBM developed DES. This is a modification of Lucifer, so what previously in 67 IBM had proposed. Okay, so that the IBM came up with the DES in 1975, so which had a block size of 64 bit and key size of 56 bits. Okay, and in the same year, the NSA suggested some modification, and in 1977, NBS adopted DES as an encryption standard. Okay, so this is the reference number. Okay, and it was in use and popular for a long time. And in 2001, NIST adopted Resendel as replacement to DES. Okay, so Resendel is another cipher which was adopted by NIST and renamed as AES, which we will discuss in the coming session. So and that was, the standard was replaced, DES by AES. Okay, so and still now, people does research and even use some modification of DES, but the original version of DES is quite discouraged to use nowadays. One of the big reason is that it is having key size of 56 bit, so this is a very small key space. Okay, so if you look at overview of DES, it is a symmetric algorithm, that means symmetric key encryption system or crypto system, where the sender and receiver both are using same key to encrypt and decrypt, and it is a block cipher, so it encrypts the message into equal size blocks and uses combination of substitution and transposition. So transpositions are nothing but permutations. So we have already discussed about what is substitution, what is transposition. So these are this kind of hybrid use of them, and this is also called a product cipher. And reason is that it have both the thing and goes through 16 cycles. So when I have discussed about FISTL cipher, I had told you that the block ciphers are usually have multiple rounds. So DES, standard DES, is having 16 rounds. Okay, and the plaintext is organized into 64-bit blocks, that is, I have already told you, and uses a 56-bit key, that is what we already know. So DES permutation and substitution-based cipher, so how it works? So it have a initial permutation phase where the input block of plain text or input text 64 bit is initially permuted. Then the 64 bit is divided into two halves, left half and right half, and each half gets 32 bits. And then take the right half and permute it again, which called also expansion permutation, because during this permutation, the number of bit expanded from 32 bit to 48 bit. Then works on key shaped, 56 bit key you have given initially, that will keep changed or keep changing for each of the 16 round. Okay, then permute the key. So there is a key permutation part of it. Okay, which is having, which gives you 48 bit key for each of the round. So these 42 bits also called as round key. Okay, then there is a jar operation. So resulting key with right half and result the result is 32 bit S box. So they use some S boxes here also. You will find in the structure. Then finally whatever result comes out, there is another permutation part or permutation phrase. So after this permutation, whatever you get, that goes to do a JOR operation with the left half of the 32 bit. Okay, so left half of 32 bit, you have seen that we have not done anything. It was as it is. Finally, it is going to be JORed with the JOR result. Okay, and then end of first cycle, and it goes for the next cycle. So the next cycle begins with the result of previous cycle as its right half and old right half without doing any change as its left half, and then it keeps repeating doing these two things. Okay, then key transformation. So it starts with 64 bit key. You can think about 16 hexadecimal digit, because in hexadecimal is digit can be represented using 4 bits, right? So if there is 16 digits, then 16 into 4 becomes 64 bit. Okay, then drop every 8th bit. If you drop every 8th bit, then you will have only this 56 bit left in your hand. Then what happens, it split this 56 bit into two parts, 28 bit and 28 bit halves. Okay, then shift each key, left shift. Okay, so this in which round, how many left shift, or how will happen, that is defined there. I'll show you, and paste both the halves. Then it will again give you 48 bit key in. Then it this 48 bit key is going to be again permuted. Okay, so how it happens, I'll show you. Okay, so first look at this. You give 64 bit key as input, but we call it 56 bit. Why? Reason is that out of this 64 bit key, every 8th bit key is a parity bit, parity check bit. So what happens? This 8th bits are only used to, used for error control. Okay, so these every 8 bits are going to be truncated or dropped. So how many bits you are going to drop? You are going to drop a total of 8 bits, and finally you will have 64 minus 8 equal to 56 bits. Okay, from here. Now look at the structure of AES. See, you give the 64 bit plain text. It goes for initial permutation first. Then the round one, round two things comes here. And on the other hand, you can see you give 64 bit key and permuted choice. There is a part here. Then which does some operations and truncate the extra bits, the error control bits, okay, parity check bits, the truncates, and they do the blip, divide the key into two halves. Okay, and then it will create round key K1 like this, and this K1 goes to the round one to do the encryption part, different operation here. Okay, in this way, you know, this process of key generation continues, and it generates K1 to K16 for each of the 16 round, you can see. Okay, and finally you do a 32-bit swap and inverse initial permutation. So you will get finally 64-bit ciphertext. Okay, so how all these things happen, so you will see. Now here, if you see the, what about this round? What is this round? What happens in this round? If you see, initial permutation happened, then it comes, you know, this round 1, round 2, round 16. So all the 16 rounds are having same structure. So the same structure means it is a structure like this. Every time, each round gets 64-bit input, which is divided into two parts, left half and right half. Okay, then right half goes for some substitution. Okay, and this substitution is done with the help of the permuted key. You know, this part again will show in bigger way. Okay, so it happens, it provides some K1 for the round one. Okay, then happens permutation, substitution, whatever things are there. Then the result is going to be jarred with the left half of the plain text. And finally you get new right half, okay, for the next round. And for the next round, new left half is, as you can see, original right half of the previous round. Okay, so and this thing keeps repeating. Okay, now if you go in further detail of this round, each of the round, it again looks like this. Okay, so you may have remember about F in the Switzer cipher. So this F is dotted lined rectangle. Okay. And here is the key generation part. Now this is one round thing. In what one round, you can see what happens in the key generation part, what happens in the round part. Okay, so you have 32-bit and 32-bit left part and right part. First, this 32-bit gets expanded to 48 bits. Okay, so we call it expansion permutation, and result becomes expanded to 48 bits. Okay, so it was 32-bit, it became 48 bits. Now you can ask that how this 32-bit can become 48 bits. So it becomes 48 bits using some expansion permutation table, and in that table you will find that it repeats some bit out of the 32 bits. Some selected bits are, you know, gets repeated to expand it to 48 bits. So no new extra bit comes from outside. It is the same 32-bit, but some bits are going to be repeated. Okay. Then on the other hand, you can see in the key generation part, something happening in parallel, that you had 56-bit, after truncating the parity check bits, that is divided into 28-bit and 28-bit, and we call it CI and DI, CI minus one and DI minus one. Okay, so this is called left part of the key, and this is called right part of the key, or C and D. Okay, because left right is used here for representation. So both the part goes for left shift. Okay, now in different round, the number of shift, number of bit it will be shifted is defined. Sometimes it is 1-bit shift, sometimes it is 2-bit shift, like this. Okay, so then after doing this, you can understand that you have 28-bit here, right? So, and here also you have 28-bit. Okay, so that is also shifted. So again, if you take both the input here in this permutation box, you are having total 28-bit plus 28-bit, 56-bit. But here for jarring, you need 48 bits. Okay, so what happens here, you have a reconstruction or a permuted choice too. There is a choice of doing shrinking these bits and selecting 48 bit out of the total 56 bit here as input came to this box. Okay, So it gives 48 bit as output and as a round key that comes here and gets JOR with the expanded right part of the plaintext. So result becomes definitely 48 bit. Okay, that 48 bit goes to a substitution box or S box. There is total 8 S boxes in DES you will find. Okay, and using those 8 S boxes, it gets again string. So these S boxes understands that which bits they need to truncate or drop from the or from out of the 48 bits generated by the JOR. Okay, so the extra bits are going to be dropped by the S boxes, and it is going to be 32 bits output. Okay, then this 32 bit output goes for a permutation again. Okay, this is a simple permutation, does not expand the strings and doesn't drop any bit. Okay, simply permutes the 32 bit and gives 32 bit output. Okay, and this is the last phase of the F function of a round. Okay, now this 32 bit output is going to be JORed with the left part of the 32 bit of your plaintext. Okay, and finally, whatever you will get, the result of the JOR, which is 32 bit, is going to be right half for your next round, and the left part of the next round is simply copied the right part of the current round without any change. Okay, so it is a kind of, you can see that partner exchange. This left part now became right part with JORing with this, and the previous right part now is acting as left part for the next round without having any change. Okay, next go to the next part. So there is this F function what I am speaking about, having basically four steps. What are those four steps? Expand 32 bit up to 8 into 6 bit blocks so that you can have 48 bit in total. Okay, so what it is saying that you expand this 32 bit using the expansion permutation so that you can have 48 bit. This is the first part of the F box. Next part is JOR, the round key, round sub key. So this 48 bit is JORed with the round sub key, come from this side, key generation side here. Then there is a pass each of 6 bit block through an S box and reduces to 32 bit. So each of this, out of this 48 bit, you take each 6 bit and send to the S box and get the output from the S box, and you will finally get 32 bit. And so it is reduced to 32 bit. Okay. Then permute the bit to promote avalanche. So finally, these 32 bits are again permuted to introduce a good avalanche effect into it. Okay. Now let's go ahead. So here is the mathematically what I was telling you regarding, F is shown in a small box. So I'm not discussing this on the, okay. So this X can be, F can be look like this. You can see F is having these four steps as I had discussed in the previous slide. Expansion permutation box, JOR, then S boxes. I had told you eight S boxes are there. Then straight permutation you have here and you get the output. So this is nothing but only F part. Okay, let's go ahead. Here is the example to encrypt a message using DES algorithm. Now, let M be the plaintext message M, which is having 0 to F. Okay, this is a string. You can treat this as a string. Okay, which is a which you need to transmit to somebody else, who is the receiver. Okay, and this is at present, this is the plaintext. Okay, now where M is in hexadecimal base 16. So it is saying that this things written and these symbols in M are in hexadecimal. So if it is in hexadecimal, then what you can understand from this, each character or each symbol in M can be represented by 4-bit, right? Because hexadecimal number can be represented by 4-bit, okay? Now, rewriting F in binary format, we get 64-bit block of text, because here we have 16 character, 16 into 4, 4-bit each character, because it is in hexadecimal, so you will get 64-bit block of text. So M equal to, in binary, 0 becomes 4 times 0, 1 becomes 0001, 2 becomes 0010, and so on, and F becomes 4 times 1. So that this is big, your plain message without encryption in binary format. Okay. Next step is dividing your message, plain text, into two part, L and R, left and right part. So 32-bit, it is broken into or split into two part. Okay. Then a key is given to you, which is this one, K equal to 133457799BBCDFF1. And this is also written in hexadecimal. Okay. So again, you need to convert this K to binary. So it is converted to binary. This one becomes 00001. Okay, 3 becomes 0001, and so on. And you get the initial key, which is 64-bit. Okay, now step one, we have key of 64-bit here, and after permutation, 56-bit using PC1, and that is permutation choice 1. Okay, so then what we do, we simply choose the permutation choice 1 to convert this 64-bit key to generate a 56-bit key. So what does this table do? This table truncates every 8-bit first from the input string. So you can see that in this table, there is no 8, no 16, no 32, or any multiple of 8 is not there. Okay. At the same time, so that means this table does not consider every 8-bit of your key. This is the first thing. Next thing is it changes the place of bit. Okay, what is your 57th bit according to this table? That will come at the first location. Okay, what is your first bit 0? That will go to the 9th location. So you can see in the 9th location it becomes 0. Okay, so in this way it does two things at a time. It does not consider every 8-bit of your key string, and also permutes by changing the bit location. Okay, according to this number arrangement, these numbers can be treated as a location number of the bit in your original key. I think it is clear to all. Okay, so finally you get K plus, which is a 56-bit key. Okay, then what we had to do? We have to divide this 56-bit key into two part, C and D, C0 and D0 for the initial round. So it is divided into 28-bit and 28-bit. Okay, no problem up to this. Then go. Then there is something I had told you regarding bit shift. So you can see here, that this is the iteration number I. This is number of bit you need to shift. I had told you that sometimes the number of bit it shifts is 1. Sometimes in some iteration it shifts for the 2 step. Okay, so it is predefined. Don't you don't need to take any headache for that. And you can see here there is CI and DI, which are 28-bit. So every iteration you can see the bits are shifted by 1 bit. See. Here you had 4 times 1 at 0th iteration when it is I equal to 0. Okay, and when I equal to 1, number of shift bit is 1, so it is shifted by 1. So once your key is generated, you need to do JOR with the expanded No, expanded 32-bit of the right part of your plain text. So go ahead. Here you have generating K1 48-bit from C1 D1, which gives you 56-bit. And this K1 is, I have already told you how it is, how we are getting. And here is the table for the choice 2, permutation choice 2. Okay. Next, how this permutation choice 2, see, permutation choice 1, this table had just converted your 64-bit to 56-bit. Okay, and permuted. But here, if you see permutation choice 2 table, it again shrink down your bit from 56-bit to 48-bit. So you understand what is the difference or use of this two permutation choice table. Okay. So that table can be also seen like this, you know, the bit, bit location and where it is going to be shifted. Okay. So this is like this, okay. And which bits are basically dropped to convert from 56-bit to 48-bit. This conversion done by dropping out this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I think it should be total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, total 8 bits are dropped, you can see here. So 56-bit was there, so say 56-bits was there, minus total 8 locations are not considered. So 56 minus 8 is equal to 48-bit you are going to have. Okay. So 48-bit K is generated. Now you can do, you can go for the JOR operation, right? So we need to do initial permutation of the masses input came, because if you see in this diagram, key A is generated, but this 48-bit we have not generated yet, right? So let's go for that. Okay, so we have masses M equal, which is of 64-bit, I have already told you. It goes for initial permutation using this initial permutation table by shifting that the bit locations, and you get initial permuted plain masses, which is this, and it is divided into two part, L0 and R0. Each of them are 32-bit. You understand this. Go ahead. Then we have to go for the expansion of this 32-bit. Okay. So how it does it happens? So here this R0 is of 32-bit. Now using this E-bit selection table or expansion bit selection table, this table convert this 32-bit to 48-bit. How it does it? It basically repeats some location multiple time so that it becomes 48-bit. If you find here, you will find some numbers are repeated here. 24 is here, and then here you can see 24 two times. Okay, so 25 here, and here also 25. So like this, few bits are repeated, or 8 bits are repeated, basically, not 8. It is 16 bits, right? 16 bits are repeated, so it is going to give you 32-bit to 48-bit output, okay? So you can look at this table like this, so that you can understand which bits are get repeated. See, the first bit is get repeated at the second position and 48th position of the expanded string. Okay, fourth bit is repeated for on the fifth location and seventh location, and like this. So from this table you can understand very clearly which bits are got repeated. Okay, so after this thing happens, our output becomes 48-bit. So we can go for this operation because we have output of 48-bit, output of expansion P box, and we have 48-bit key also, what I have shown you how to generate. Okay, so we can do this JOR operation and we can have this 48-bit. Okay, so the K1 is 48-bit now, expanded R0 is 48-bit now, we do jaw operation among K1 and expanded R0, and we get this is the result of jaw operation. We have to go for these S boxes to convert this 48 bits back to 32 bits. Right. So here is one S box I am showing you. This is S box 1. And these are the index, you can see the column numbers are given, that is 15 columns, 0 to 15, and there is 4 rows, 0 to 3. So this rows can be, this rows can be addressed by 2-bit binary number, right? Because double 1 means 3, and these columns are possible to address using 4-bit binary number. Okay, because 4-bit, 4 times 1 will give you 15, 4 times 0 will give you 0. Okay, so total, if you want to address this column any of this cell in the table, you need 2-bit for addressing the row and 4-bit for addressing the column. So total, you will need 6-bit. Okay, but how many bits you have? Here you have 48 bits, right? So how many cell you can address here? 48 by, you need 6-bit. So 48 by 6, 8 cells you can address. So as this B1 is 6-bit, we need to take out 2-bit and 4-bit, right, for rows and column. So how we do this thing? We take the middle 4-bit, take the middle 4-bit out of 6-bit of B, to select this column, okay, and from both the end we take 1-bit and 1-bit, and this 2-bit we use to choose or select one row. Okay, so using B1 we can have we can choose one row from out of this and one column from out of this, and which will give you one cell as a you can select one cell out of this, right, like that. Okay, so this operation, in short, we write like this: S1, B1, S2, B2, S3, B3, and up to S8, B8. Why S1 and S up to S8? Because we have actually 8 S boxes, and we have 8 Bs here, right? So B1 will be used to pick one value from this table, from S1 table. B2 will be used to pick one value from S2 table, and so on. Okay, and in these tables you will find that each numbers entered are possible to represent using 4-bit binary. Okay, so from 8 substitution box you are going to choose 8 numbers basically, which are possible to represent using 4 bits. So that means in total how many bits you are going to choose? 8 number into 4, that means 32 bit. Okay, so that is the reason the output of S box part is going to be 32 bits. So if you go to the next slide, here I am showing you the 8 S boxes. Okay, this is fixed for the DS algorithm. Okay, so that can be also written like this in some places. Okay, so finally, whatever the output of the S boxes we are getting for our example is this. Okay, then this output of the S boxes, 32 bits, are going for a straight permutation, and which will give you 32-bit output. So here is the permutation table used to permute this 32 bits, and it gives the final output of the F, which had the 4 steps, and final step was this permutation. So final permutation happened, and it is going to give you this 32-bit as output. Okay. Next, what happens? The output of the AF, this 32-bit, is going to be jarred with the left part of your message, okay? And which is going to give you the right part for the next round, okay? So it was in a we was working on R1, so sorry R0. Now this is next for next round it will be R1. So R1 equal to L0, you know, L0 comes from here, then jar with output of the F. Okay, output of the F, because F, if you think this one as this this box as F, it is having basically two input. One is R0, 32 bit, and another is this K. I mean, say here's a zero. Okay, K0. Okay, so that is what is here. Okay, K goes one step ahead, so K1. Okay, so output of the F, jar together and get this result, and that is going to be the R1. That means the right part for the next round. Okay, so what will be the left part of the next round? It will be, you know, without doing anything. So okay, this, there is a notation mismatch. It should be L1. L1 equal to R0. Okay, L1 equal to R0 should be there. Okay, and it will keep doing this. So in this way, you will, you know, do for 16 round, and you will get.